So I'm going to discuss one other non-solution. So we'll call this one number 0B, which is to use a trusted third party. So here's the idea that we have some very, very trustworthy place and we'll make it green. People trust things that are green. So we have this very trusty place called Trusty Keys, and Trusty Keys has a shared secret with each individual in the network. So now if Alice and Bob want to communicate, the protocol is Alice sends a message to Trusty Keys that says she wants to communicate with Bob. So that's step one of the protocol. What Trusty Keys will do is generate some new key, some new secret key, and we'll call that KAB because it's for Alice to communicate with Bob. So in step three, Trusty Keys will send the new key to both Alice and Bob, and it will send it encrypted using the key that's already shared between those two parties. So what it sends to Bob is the encryption using KB, the shared key between Bob and Trusty Keys, of something that says Alice's name concatenated with the actual key. And what gets sent to Alice is encrypted with KA, the shared key between Alice and Trusty Keys, and the name Bob along with KAB. At this point, both Alice and Bob know KAB and can communicate securely using KAB to encrypt messages between them. So the quiz to see if you understand third-party key distribution. What could go wrong with this protocol? So the choices are Trusty Keys can read all the messages that happen between A and B over their encrypted channel. Trusty Keys can impersonate any customer that shares a key with Trusty Keys. And some evil party C could tamper with messages in step three to steal the key AB and set up a different key between Alice and Bob and then steal their traffic.